Number three for the best game of the year is definitely going to be Pokemon for me. The way it basically brought back the same love that I had for the series since like Gold and Silver was just amazing. Having the 3D graphics, the Pokemon moving and making sounds on the battlefield, the way the fights were nice and quick but still looked great, the length of it, the tons of online options, all that stuff wrapped up in a little perfect package of love basically made Pokemon easily my number three best game of the year. Put so many hours into it, it's definitely just a wonderful game that anybody really could get into and really enjoy once more if you were a Pokemon fan. Number two is Rayman Legends. This one just slipped under like a bunch of people's radar and I don't have a fucking clue as to why it does, because it's such a great game. Not only is it a pretty lengthy game, but it also consists of actual Rayman, the last one that came out. It actually has levels from that game in this game as well, including co-op as well. So, I mean, it just has so much content. Some of the levels are amazing, especially the music ones. And overall, I mean, I was just digging this game so much. Like, the second I turned it on, I was like, this is something special. This is that old feeling of that platform. And this reminded me of when I played Super Mario Brothers for the Wii with Alex. And it's just an amazing, amazing time in terms of platforming. And brings back that old school funness. I don't really think this one was hard to see. Last of Us is easily one of my favorite games ever created, to be honest. Its story is engaging. Its gameplay is both fun and creepy. Its online is fabulous. It's just overall one of the best complete package games I've seen in a long time. A game where I played through the single player twice and then I actually played online for more than like 20-30 hours easy. It was just such a gripping tale on top of having the extra stuff that it is best, one of the best games I played since like Halo 2, you know, and it's just really a phenomenal game and loved every moment of it, and that's really going to be my number one game of the year. Saying that, games I want to say that honorable mention are Tomb Raider, excellent, excellent game, and Fire Emblem Awakening, another game that just sucked me in, and I was like, this is such a great fucking game. It had so much content. And then another game I'm going to throw out there that I've been playing with Kelly is the new Super Mario Bros. For the Wii U. Tons of fun. There are some issues, and I'll get to that in the review, but overall, if you're looking for that old school Mario mixed with new school, this is probably the best combination I've ever seen for them, and definitely worth checking out. So those are my honorable mentions there, but my top three games are Pokemon X and Y, number two, Rayman Legends, and the final and third one, or the first one, I guess, in this sense, would be Last of Us. Definitely game of the year for myself. So overall, excellent year for gaming, and I would love to hear your choices. List them below, your top three, and, you know, add a couple of honorable mentions for you. And have a good one, guys, and we are in the new year, so let's celebrate by talking about what's coming first. Tomb Raider Definitive Edition. I can't wait to play that, and I will try to review it. And also, we got to talk a little bit about Dragon Ball Z Battle of Z. I don't know if that's going to be good. It kind of looks like shit, but we shall see when it comes out. And so more reviews coming, including the Wii U game Super Mario Bros. Wii U. So be on the lookout. Whitey out. Have a good one.